you are now tuning in to Take a Seat with G. Toodles.
Hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Take a Seat with G, who is me. Today we are here and we're going to talk to artists and creatives about anything and everything. And today we have the first female on the platform. I am so excited, okay? Because all my guests have been guys. Not hating on y'all, but today by my side we have the beautiful Kibra, Toronto-based artist that is everywhere. Y'all need to check her music out. She is dope. And I'm so happy that I just have, you know, I'm just going to acknowledge more right now. That you're the first woman on the platform, okay? Let's get it. I'm so happy. You know, my fellow artists, my fellow female artists, it's time for you guys to come and take a seat with me. Take a seat with G. Yeah. All right. We're going to get started with these questions because I'm excited to talk about everything that you've been working on and what you're going to be working on. So I want to know, what I ask everybody is, when did you fall in love with music?
I say this all the time, like I really fell in love with music probably before I could even talk. Mm-hmm. I definitely was singing before I could even put words together, and I started playing piano at the age of 3, so it's just been honestly like the one constant in my life was really music. So
okay,
yeah, from a very, very tender young age.
All right, so dope. So you still play the piano right now?
Don't ask me to. I mean, if I need to in my room, you know, I like the last time I performed with the piano, I was very unengaged with the crowd. It was not cute at all. Like, my eyes were closed and I was rocking back and forth. It was just not a vibe. So I definitely would like to, you know, get to that point. I just think I need a little bit more practice and intentionally, putting my mind to the craft of playing a little bit more. Because I did have quite a big break, like in high school. I just was like, I don't want to do any of this. So, I just kind of like use it to help me write music and stuff like that, just personally, and just, you know, to de-stress a little. But to perform, not yet. Not there yet.
Okay. No, we're going to get there. You're going to get there. Okay. So when did you start doing music professionally? Like, when did you, do you remember when you started? I'm sure you do.
Sure,
but.
Yeah. I would say, like, I put out my first single just kind of for fun. Mm-hmm. Like, I had no idea what I was doing. So I wouldn't say I was a professional yet then. But that was, I believe, in 2017. And then I just kind of, like, was like, yeah, like, what am I doing? Like, I have no idea what I'm doing. And so it took me a little bit to kind of find my footing. And I would say, like, end of 2018, 2019 was when things, I started really taking it a lot more seriously.
Okay. So, yeah, that's not long ago, but yeah. Okay.
Are we still fresh?
Yeah.
Fresh?
No, but you don't seem like you're fresh, girl. You got the vocals. Okay.
Oh, thank you.
So let's talk about your recent EP, And It Was Good.
Yeah.
What inspired that? Because I heard that, I'm like, okay, because I heard, I went through your music, and then when I heard that, I'm like, okay, I see growth. So what inspired that and the title?
So, I don't know if you're a Christian or not, but in the book of Genesis, God made the earth and it was good.
Yeah.
So that's kind of where the inspiration for the title came from, just because I felt like the music that I was working on at the time was really music that I felt like totally confidently just very, very, or totally confident in.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just really impressed by myself. I was happy with myself. And so that's where, like, the title came from. Like, just really being able to produce something from myself. Like, it was from my head. Everything was written from on my own. And just to really, like, have, to be able to put something out in the world that is made by me. That I at least felt like was good.
Mm-hmm.
So that's where the title came. And, like, you know, all the songs are just were just really, like, not intentionally made to go on a project. They were really just created just as I went through life.
Yeah.
And yeah, I was like, this is a project right here. Like, these five little songs, they're projects.
Well, you can feel it.
I felt it.
Yeah.
So it was nice. It was just a good collection of music that I was happy to put out.
Okay, I like that. Mm-hmm. All right, so let's talk about the music video you shot in Africa. Mm-hmm. I was like, okay, girl, visuals. So I want to know.
Which one? Well, you can't tell me which one because there's a couple out there.
Okay, but I wrote it down. Hold on. Not you. Because I skipped through the questions. I'm moving around. No, it was all that.
Okay.
In Ghana.
Yes.
Yes. Love the visuals. I was like, okay, giving earth vibes. I like that. So how was it with the, like, just leaving here and going over there and shooting that?
It was an incredible experience. I mean, huge shout out to my team out in Ghana, Majid and the whole team.
So you got an international team?
Papa, all y'all.
Okay,
all y'all.
Period.
I love you so much.
Shout out to you.
And there's Trinity, who produced the track, and Joey. Big shout out to them. They really made it very easy for me to get things done, and are so committed and so hardworking. And so, you know, it was an incredible experience. And even big shout out to Skyscraper as well. He was the love interest in the video. He did an incredible job. I feel like I'm missing a couple people, but you know who you are.
Shout out to y'all. But like, tell me about the process, like going to do that, because we're westernized here over here,
yeah,
and over there, you know,
it's totally different.
Yeah, very different.
Yeah. So I mean, it's important again to have like those people that are from there. I know Ni, for example, spoke like the language of the location, like the people who like fish there and work there and stuff. So it was really because of him that we were able to shoot there, so that he could communicate properly.
Okay.
Secure that location for us. And you know, things just work on a different time in Ghana, so you just have to be very patient and just, you know, understand, really have a strong belief in divine timing.
Okay.
So you know, things get pushed and, you know, like things may not feel like they're coming together, but then once they do, it's
beautiful.
Incredible.
Yeah.
You know, the stylist and the set designer, she was absolutely a joy to work with. She did such a great job. It was one of the few videos. I'm always extremely hands-on and very much, I like take the lead on every project I work on.
Mm-hmm.
But this project, I very much felt supported, and like the burden of doing the work and stuff wasn't completely on me just because of how incredible everyone was. So
love that. Love that. So since we're speaking about Africa right now, how was it telling African relatives that you wanted to pursue music professionally?
Yeah. So, you know, like this is usually such like a tragic story for African artists, but it honestly wasn't for me. I feel like the main focus was just like, oh, like we don't want you to quit school or you have to have something in the background. But other than that, like, completely supportive. My mom, anytime she sees a video, she cries. Like, it's the cutest thing. She's very supportive. She comes to all my events, and she's like my number one supporter, as well as my uncle's like my father figure. And so they're extremely supportive in every way that they can be, and I'm just honestly so in debt and just so happy and honored that I have that in my corner.
I love that, because we see a lot, like you said, tragic stories where it's like our African parents want us to be doing, they want us to be doctors, lawyers, but when it's time to do music or anything to do with the media, they want to scream. Like, I wish a lot more African parents or just people, because I feel like it goes into the younger generations where it's like, okay, I'm going into school to do nursing, and it's like they hate it.
Right.
So I want to, like, you know, tell the African people out there, it's okay to be creative. Africans are very creative, and I feel like this is our place. Like, this is our talents and stuff like that. We need to, you know, because Afrobeats is popping right now, Afrofusion. Everybody in Africa right now is popping. I just feel like people need to let these people shine. Like, let everybody shine, and you'll see beautiful stuff coming out. Because I feel like people are just so closed off because they can't do what they love. And look at you. You're doing what you love, and you're doing it beautifully.
Thank you.
So Let's talk about how you have songs about love. Because I know it ain't these Toronto men inspiring this music. So, what is going on? Because I want to know. I know it ain't no Toronto men inspiring this. So, please, who is inspiring this music?
You know, honestly, this question, like, I hate to disappoint, you know? But, like, a lot of the music, a lot of the love songs, of course, they are drawing from, like, very personal places. But sometimes I'm just like the biggest empath, and so sometimes really what it is just me like kind of like, what's the word I'm trying, absorbing people's stories. People come to me with everything, girl. I got the tea on many folk, like, you know. So I very much feel these things, and you know, I'm like, a lot of the people come for support and whatever, and so I'm thinking very deeply, and so in the back of my mind, it's always there. And so a lot of the songs that I write are inspired by some of the stories, mainly like women are going through in their romantic endeavors, whether it be positive or whether it be negative. And just what I try to instill in my music is just messages, regardless of whether it's like a happy love song or a heartbreak song, is just really to make sure that you are loving yourself first.
Period.
Being in a relationship that is serving you, that you are, you know, also kind of doing your part in the relationship, you know, making sure that you're still a queen. But at the same time, yeah, like just really pushing like the agenda of like healthy, non-toxic relationships.
Yeah.
And leaving when it is.
We're getting into that right now. Let's talk about your song "Won't Wait." Yes. Have you ever found yourself in a situation where you waited for any, you know?
No.
Period. Just like that.
I ain't waited.
Because I feel like a lot of women will wait for men to get their stuff together.
Right.
And
there's no shame in it.
Yeah.
There's no shame in it. There's many success stories and stuff. I think just personally for myself is that I'm like really on a mission, you know? And so when I feel like it's not even just about waiting for someone to get their things together, but when I feel like the process of them doing that is affecting like my livelihood and how I am, you know, navigating in the world and trying to move forward in my career, that's when I'm just like,
It ain't it. I know that's right. Yeah. How do you feel about being a female artist in Toronto?
That's a big question.
Loaded one, huh?
It's a very loaded question. I think Toronto is a great city. I was born and raised here. I think being, you know, kind of in a lot of spaces that are community driven is very helpful, just because I'm able to learn and, you know, even... I feel like there's an exchange of like learning and teaching, and I'm able to be in these spaces that aren't necessarily degrading or invalidating. I definitely have experiences that are very positive in this city. However, of course, it comes with its, you know, batch of not good stuff.
Yeah.
You know, people really try to like oversell themselves in order to get something out of you, or kind of manipulate situations in their behalf because they just think they can, and because you're a woman, there are times where you may feel powerless in situations. So, you know, I do my best to avoid it, but even in those situations, I try to like mentally prepare myself and, you know, have the proper supports around me, so that, like, you know, grace of God doesn't go left. But so far, thankfully, nothing insanely crazy.
Okay, so what about, I feel like, because I literally created this platform to support artists, give people a platform, I feel like we don't really have that like it used to be back in the day. Maybe back in the day, I feel like they were just more catering to American artists, so they would come here and come on shows and stuff like that. How do you feel about the industry here and how it is? How is it treating you? Just how do you feel? Do you feel like you get support outside, more support outside than in-house, or Like, how was it for you?
I mean, the numbers don't lie. Like, you know, I definitely feel like support, especially depending on the song, comes heavily from, you know, like the States and Africa and the UK. Like, you know, I say that, I don't want to say that without saying that there is tons of love out here, mm-hmm. you know, and I think I'm humble enough to understand that, like, there's just a lot more work that I need to do
yeah.
to get the recognition that I feel like I deserve. And so, yeah, like I said, like, I'm just a young bug, you know, just bubbling. And I think, like, with time, I'll get there.
Amen.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I know that's right. You will. So I want to talk about your recent retreat that you had with artists.
Oh, yeah.
Tell us about that, because you don't hear that often where people have, like, artist retreats. I want to know the nitty gritty. How did you come about it? What did you do? Why did you do it?
Yeah.
You know.
It's actually the first time I'm kind of talking about this in public.
Exclusive.
Low key, but yeah, so I just kind of had this idea just really out of, you know, conversations I've had with artists and conversations I've had with myself about really, you know, not having access to spaces and not having the time to create, like, quality, engaging content. And, you know, nowadays we understand how important that is. And so that paired with my, again, like, really strong belief in community and really understanding that, like, you know, we're nothing without community. I wanted to build, like, a community-centered program that allows for artists to collaborate with each other in a safe space.
Yeah.
And learn with each other and really just create content so that we can all push each other and learn from each other and just get those algorithms going. Mm-hmm.
I feel like that's very important because it's really, like, all men to themselves.
Yeah.
Down. You know, some people are just like that. It's like, oh, they just care about, you know, me making it or whatever. But it's like, if you do it together, it will go faster.
Absolutely.
And you guys will get there.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? So I feel like that's really nice and lovely.
Mm.
I love that.
Yeah.
So can you talk about who was there?
Yeah, sure. There were incredible people. We have Ibu, who's filming for us today. He was there. Along with Ebenezer, he was one of the photographers. We also had Kai, who is a violinist,
mm-hmm.
and Brielle, who's an artist slash pianist slash producer. Dallas, who is a producer slash engineer. We had Terrence Penny, who is also an artist. Mez Marie, who's also an artist. Wave Montega, who's also an artist.
There was featured in one
people.
Of your songs.
Yes, he is featured on one of my songs. We had Dell. We had who's a videographer slash artist. There was a lot of people.
Love that.
Louisa, she's a photographer and she's like my sister. Shanique was also my sister. She was there as well as the content creator. And Aisha, who's a photographer. Yeah, we had a few people. I feel like I'm forgetting some. Andy, what's with Andy?
Okay, he was there too.
Yeah,
that's my dog.
there's a few people there. Yeah, I mean, the list goes on.
Okay.
Yeah.
And these are all Toronto people.
Love
it.
GTA.
Yeah. Oh, look at that. What is your own personal favorite song and why? Like, of your
By
own?
Myself?
Yes.
My all-time favorite personal song? It's hard to say. I think Another Sun.
Okay.
In terms of what I have out now.
Yeah.
We ain't gonna talk about what we got in the vault, but
yeah.
In terms of what I have out now, I think, like, Another Sun is just such a feel-good, uplifting song for us melanated folks, and it just always is a joy to perform.
Yeah.
And I feel like it's really inspiring, and you know, I've gotten some of the most endearing messages and responses from that song, and so I'm very, very proud of that one. It's definitely close to my heart.
Love it. And can we get like, when are we getting new music? Because your last EP was 2020.
Right.
Came out in 2020.
Right, yeah.
When are we gonna get something new? Is it gonna be an EP, singles?
Yeah, so I put out a single in February, I believe. And it's just going to be a couple more singles up to my album,
Oh,
my debut
an
album.
album.
Yes.
Oh,
I won't tell you when,
it's okay.
but it's coming this year.
Okay.
That's what I say.
Just hope you have a listening party, you know, a little preview. Oh, I'm
I'll
gonna be there. Take a seat when G will
be
be there. Yes, I'm excited. I love it. I love going to these things and seeing, you know, you getting in your zone, showing us what what you've been working on. Random question though. Did you ever consider joining like a girl band?
actually, had an A&R reach out to me from Sony that wanted me to be in a girl band with these two other girls, and I declined it. Because here's the thing, I love my women, I love working with women, but I don't know, I just, especially with girls that I don't know, it's one thing if they were like my friends and I trusted and I know. Like, I just feel like the industry is just too ruthless for a bond that isn't even really there. You know what I mean? And so I just don't really like to be in the mix. Like, and I usually am not the one that is starting the drama, but if the drama is brought to me, honey, I will run. So I just try to avoid those situations all in all. So I mean, maybe one day, you never know. But just for now, I think I'm good just as Kibra.
For me, I would, I don't know. Girl bands, literally, as you said, always, there's always something. And then they always break up. And it's like, what was the point? You know?
Yeah, it's
So,
kind of sad.
yeah, I'm here
I
for the
mean,
solo dolo.
yeah.
I'm here for it. For
I mean,
you.
shout out to the girls groups though, because they were like, the Destiny's
Back in the
Child, NSYNC, the
day.
Spice Girls.
Yes.
I don't care if you ever disbanded, you will always be together in my heart. And it
Exactly.
definitely influenced like my musicality and even just my ability to blend with other singers and
Yeah.
sing with other singers. So there's definitely positives to being in a girl group, but
Yeah, it is. Yeah. But we all they always cover the bad
politics
stuff.
wise.
Exactly. That's all it is in the media these days. If you were to collab with a Toronto artist that you haven't collabed with, who would you want it to be and why?
Oh my God, this is like such a loaded question. I feel like I don't know. I feel like I can't say something without hurting feelings.
It's not about the
I
people. This is hurt their
don't know.
feelings if
Who
you
would I
have
say?
to. It's not about them, baby. You gonna be all right. You will be okay.
I don't know. Honestly, I really don't know. There's like so many artists that are like so talented right now. I'll say Savannah Rae.
Ah,
Love Savannah Rae. I feel
yeah.
like, yeah, she's on top of her game.
Yeah. She's doing her
Love
thing.
her music. Love
Yeah.
her music. Love her sound. Love the texture of her voice.
Yeah, Savannah Ray, if you're
Yeah.
watching, baby, she's right here. She wants to collab, and we gonna make it happen. Yeah, you already told us about the album, but now we're gonna get into this game because I heard you like games. We're very excited. We
Very
wanna no,
excited.
I'm excited
I
because you
love
know games
games.
on this show
I'm
doesn't
so
really,
competitive.
you
Oh,
know.
that's why I asked you earlier. I asked her, I was like, hey, like, what's the high score? Because
And the people, not even to shit on my favorite, my guest, my lovely guest, but you guys were not bringing it like that. But
Listen, I'm talking all this shit, but if I
freeze,
freeze, I'll just
girl.
leave. I
No,
won't take a seat. I will leave with G. I will leave. I'm screwing
gonna
myself up.
be fine. I have faith in you. Today, I have faith in you. So, we are going to play Song Association. For people that don't know what this is, I'm gonna give her a word. She has 10 seconds to sing a song with the word in it. So, she has to get to the word in it. And yeah, she has to sing because we played the. You know what? It's okay. Let's just play the game because we're not gonna get into that. But yes, I want you to sing, you know, have your little, give us a little taste of what Kibra is. Okay, the star. So the first word is it. 10 seconds on the
When
clock.
I get you all alone,
A.
baby, you know where you're home with.
A.
Ain't a thing you'll find better than this. That's it.
Period.
I'm it.
Oh!
That's my song.
Yes, it is! Yes, it is! You got, oh, I'm so happy! Okay, no, let's keep this going. Let's keep this going. Okay, the next word is that.
Oh, these are all my songs.
Come on!
All that. Mmm, skin, how I like my coffee.
Mmm!
Yeah. I love how you trace the curves of my body.
Whoa, vocals. And that was shot in Ghana. That's the one we're talking about. Okay. The next word is mine.
Baby, you should be mine again.
Oh.
Baby, we should make the dream for real. Away,
no, no.
CMC.
Love it. Oh my God. No, you're doing it. You're doing it. No, guys, this is what I'm talking about. When I say you have to sing, this is what I'm talking about. Okay? If you can't sing, please just sing. Be expressive. Sing. No, I love it. We're going. Okay. The next word is around.
I want you around. Around. I want you around.
Hey, come on. Around, around, around. Hey, Snow Allegra. Yes. And you covered this, didn't you?
I did.
Yes. Look at me. Wow. Anyways. Okay, the next word is you.
You. There's so many songs. Oh my god. Can I sing the same song again or no?
No.
No? Okay. You are the sunshine of my life. That's why I'll always be around.
Hey.
You are the apple of my eye.
Nah.
Stevie Wonder.
She's winning. Winning. The next word is love.
Love. Never knew.
Oh,
but I knew once we started.
You what? Oh, yes, Keisha Cole. Yeah. Oh, let's get it. Okay, the next word, we got some more words, is no.
No, 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 no. Anything, yeah, yeah, yeah,
hey,
yeah.
Hey.
Anything, no, 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 no.
Oh. Destiny Child for y'all. Okay. Next word is find.
Find. You'll never find no one in this lifetime to love you like I do. So never mind the things that people say that I'll never hurt you. You'll never find. A little bit of reggae.
Gone gals. Okay.
You need some more words on that.
Right? This girl's finishing. She just finished everything. Sorry.
Sorry?
Yeah.
And I'm so sorry, baby, but I'm in love with another man.
I was just at her concert.
Don't
remind me. Oh. Oh. Okay. You had a nerve right there, girl. That's one of them songs that, whew, if you're in a situation, one of them ones, see the girls that be loving the other men. The girls that be loving these other men. This is the one for you. And last but not least, yes. Mood.
Mood? I'm in a big mood.
Oh, oh.
I feel you.
Something with your okay. No, she's the she got 10 out of 10. People, 10 out of 10.
Period.
10.
Period.
Out of 10. No, Kiba, you shut it down.
Thank you.
This is how you take a seat with G, okay? Example. Come on. She sat here. She did what she had to do. And look at her. You won. You're the first winner of Song Association. Okay, girl.
Let's see. Someone beat my score.
Yeah, I would like to see it. Whoever comes here next, you got some competition.
Yep.
Okay. So we're gonna finally update our playlist. So we have a playlist on Spotify and Apple Music. You have two songs. It could be your songs, whoever other song, any other artist song, to be honest. But if you wanna update our playlist so people could go and check out, download our playlist, add it to their playlist.
Should I pick the song now?
Yes. Oh, on the spot.
What's the vibe of the playlist?
You know what? It's giving everything and anything.
It's giving everything.
Yeah, it's okay. Giving.
There's this song.
Yeah.
That I'm obsessed with right now. I'm actually gonna post a cover to it very soon.
Okay.
But it's called "Love Don't Cost a Dime."
Okay.
By Magix and Arya Star.
Okay.
10 out of 10. I love it.
Such Arya Star, the vibe killer.
Yes.
This is Samaritan.
Yes.
There we go.
It's a very okay. good song. It's a very good song. It's a song you want to listen to. Like, you know, you don't even have to be in love. The song will fabricate the love in your mind.
Wow.
And will think you.
Them ones are dangerous.
Dangerous.
Yeah.
It's insanity. But it's okay. It's welcome. It's welcome.
The next song.
The next song. You know what? Let's do All That.
All That.
All That by Igos Truly.
Kibra. That's right. She has taken the seat with G. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Please like, comment, share, subscribe. Go on YouTube, go on her channel. It's going to be down in the description below. Subscribe. Her socials. Follow. Like. Do everything. Stay updated because she said that music is coming. We have more content coming. So thank you guys so much for tuning in. This was amazing. I'm so happy. Thank you so much for taking the seat with me.
Me.
You are more than welcome to come back. Come and finish the Sing a Song Association. We have to find a new game now because she killed it. I'm so happy. Don't forget to leave a comment down below. Just, you know, interact with us. And thank you so much for tuning in. Bye.